And a good day to each and every one of you. J7409 here with a hurricane update for 2018 on this day of Saturday, the 21st of April, 2018. And we're like 40 days away from the beginning of hurricane season. And for you guys that follow me, I've been showing you how warm the waters are. They've been warm all winter, really, to a certain extent, kind of above average big time. Well, I want to make clear right now that there are currently no tropical cyclones in any ocean basin. There are currently no tropical cyclones, okay? But the National Hurricane Center has their eyes on a few systems. So, I want to explain this to you, okay? You need to know this stuff. Invest. Now, an invest is an area of disturbed weather for which the National Hurricane System, or Center rather, is interested in collecting specific data such as microwave satellite imagery, specific model guidance. Now, while the National Hurricane Center says that designating a disturbance as a invest does not correspond to any particular likelihood of development of the system into a tropical cyclone, it is generally known that if the National Hurricane Center designates an invest system is of interest to them, okay, and we've got some that they're watching, it's usually an interest to them, and usually has at least a low chance of subtropical or tropical development. The ATCF, which is the Automated Tropical Cyclone Forecast System, it contains specific information for the active invest, similar to active tropical cyclones. And that information is displayed right here if it's available. And this page updates every 15 minutes. So I wanted to show you guys this. We have this going on now. You see the date right in here. Okay, you see the date right here, April 21st, 2018. Now look, the wind's really low. The pressure is high, 1,004 millibars for this particular system right here. We have it over here. I'm just showing you guys this. There are some systems that they are watching. So, and we come on down. It shows the map where they think it'll go. Here is 93S Invest. Now, its winds are 25 knots. Still not tropical storm force. A tropical storm has to have winds of at least 39 miles per hour. Okay. None of these systems do. But I wanted to show you guys this. See, they're already tracking some, okay? This blows your mind, doesn't it? This is 96S Invest, and there's your locations. If you wanted to check them all out, there's a storm right in there. It's going to take a loop. We'll see what happens with it. I don't think any of these will materialize, but who knows? We've had bipolar weather off for a while now. We're going to have to wait and see what happens, but I really don't think these will materialize into tropical storms. They might. I'll keep my eyes on them. We have 94P Invest here. Everybody sees the date. These are updated every 15 minutes, as you can see. So some of these do have some confection, and I'll tell you all about them coming up right now. Don't go anywhere. Now, the tropical weather discussion, all of this information, guys, it is gathered up and it's based on satellite imagery, the weather observations and the radar, and also the meteorological analyst, okay? It's all put together. That's how they get this, okay? Now, the monsoon trough, well, the monsoon trough passes through the coastal sections near 07 north, 12 west, and extends to 03 north, 19 west. And it continues from 03 north 19 west, crossing the equator along 27 west. And you see the rest right there. The meat of this scattered moderate to strong convection is noted north of the ITCZ within 30 nautical mile line from 02 north to 31 west to 02 north to 36 west. And you see the rest of the locations. Now, what's going on with this? Scattered moderate convection is within 60 nautical miles south of the trough between 16 west and 20 west, and south of the trough within 60 nautical miles of 2 north and 14 west. That's the area of this convection that's going on in that area. And so far as the Gulf of Mexico, its stationary front extends from central Florida out over the far eastern Gulf from the Tampa Bay area to around 26 north to 91 west, where it transitions to a warm front to inland Mexico near Corpus Christi. The front will weaken through this morning, with its remnants lifting northward as a warm front this afternoon, ahead of a cold front that's expected to reach the Texas coast early Sunday. And this front will be preceded by a line of scattered showers and thunderstorms. The cold front should reach from Mississippi Delta to the Bay of Campeche by tomorrow night, Sunday night, from the Florida Big Bend area to the Yucatan Peninsula on Monday night, and then move slowly southeastward Tuesday, and eventually being southeast of the area by Wednesday evening. Do we have any more convection or cyclonic action going on? Well, in the Caribbean Sea, upper-level cyclonic wind flow with a trough spans the entire area. Now, the trough cuts across central Cuba toward the Gulf of Urba and Colombia. Lingering rain showers cover the area that extends from Nicaragua near 13 northward to the Bahamas and near 20 northward between 68 west, eastern sections of Hispaniola, and 88 west in parts of Central America. Surface to low-level cyclonic wind flow is in the southwest corner of this area. Rain showers are possible from 15 north southward, from 70 west westward. And we've got more chances of rain showers in this area that goes all the way to Guadeloupe. Now, the Atlantic high pressure, it's going to maintain fresh to locally strong trade winds across the South Central Caribbean Sea through early Sunday. Okay, so you need to keep this in mind. You guys are going to get some rain, a little bit of windy conditions. So far as the Atlantic Ocean goes, what's going on here? Well, a cold front is analyzed from just to the east of Bermuda southward, okay, where it becomes stationary to Cape Canaveral and to across central Florida to the Gulf of Mexico near Tampa Bay. A surface trough is within 150 nautical miles to 210 nautical miles to the southeast of the cold front. Scattered moderate convection is within 60 nautical mile line from 27 north to 71 west, 26.5 north to 72 west, and within 30 nautical mile lines from 27 north to 73 west to 27 north 75 west. Similar convection is within this 60 nautical mile southeast of the trough, east of 64 west, and east of the trough within 30 nautical miles of 27 north 66 west. Okay, the cold front portion of the above mentioned front will become stationary east to west along 26 north by tonight. Remnants of this front will lift northward tomorrow near gale force. Southeast wind flow will develop north of the Bahamas by Monday. Okay, and to the east of the surface, the low that will shift eastward across the southeastern United States, that surface low will move northeastward along the Georgia and South Carolina coast Tuesday, and it's going to drag a cold front across the northwest waters during the middle part of next week. Here we go. An upper level cyclonic circulation center is near 34 north, 15 west, or about 300 nautical miles to the north of the Canary Islands. Okay. So I, once again, there are no tropical storms, but there is these systems that they are watching. And here's a floater image of 92 West, Invest 92. As you can see, it moving around here. It's not a tropical storm. These are systems that the National Hurricane Center is watching right now. I just wanted you guys to know I'm keeping up on this. First sign of anything that I saw, I wanted to share it with you. We are 40 days away from hurricane season beginning. So, with that all said and done, you know, if you live along coastlines anywhere in the United States, if you don't have your hurricane preparedness kit together, you might want to start getting prepared for it, so you won't have to do it in case one just pops up overnight or during an afternoon or early morning hours that we're not aware of. You've already got that done. That's a good thing to do. As we turn on the latitude and the longitudes, you can see here where this is, right in here. Remember, I was talking about five when I was reading the tropical discussion for you a while ago. Here we go. It's 5 and 65. Boom. You can see it right in here. Pretty weird to see it right now, isn't it? Does it have any forecast points? No, because it's not an actual tropical storm. Does it have any wind in it? Well, yes, it does. Sporadically, you can see it over here. No big deal. The low winds in it, hardly any at all. Medium winds, none. High winds, doesn't have any. So that's a good thing. All of this is great. What does the temps look like? This water is hot. 82, 86, 83. So we'll keep our eyes on it, okay? And the rest of them also. If anything does develop, I will let you know. I just wanted to bring this up and show you the National Hurricane Center's already watching systems. It doesn't mean they're tropical storms. There's not any right now. I can't stress that enough. But they could turn into something. I doubt any of these that I've showed you this morning will right now. I hope they don't. But if they do, I'll let you know. And we need to keep our eyes on this stuff and everybody be prepared. Thank you so much for watching, subscribing, subbing, sharing this weather information, the likes, everything you do for me, I appreciate it. The people who give me donations, all of you, thank you so very much. You help me keep on doing what I'm doing and why I do it, to help keep people safe. Everybody have a great day. Much peace, love, and kindness to all.